Oh, man. Anyways, man.
Wait. Are we still talking about the Nats?
No, we're talking about the Nats still.
I was going to say, slightly related to the Nats, do you know that Metro actually denied them to run extra coverage after the Nats games?
Oh.
Past a certain amount of hour?
You know what?
Because a couple weeks ago, people were actually stranded out there because Metro stopped running. And so Metro told them today that, no, they're not going to do that anymore.
For those of you that don't know, the Metro is the underground train system that runs in Washington, D.C. Kind of like the BART in San Francisco or the Haitunguetang rail out in Tokyo.
Just public
Tokyo.
Transportation.
Right. And it's subsidized by the government, and it's the shittiest fucking system in the world besides New York and Baltimore. These motherfuckers at Metro constantly raise the price, give contracts, billion-dollar contracts to motherfuckers, and things steadily get worse. And this is just another example, okay? The game ran late last week because the rain and shit pushed back the game, the Nationals game. And, you know, it would have only taken Metro staying open maybe an extra hour for everybody to get home because it closes down at like 11:30, 11:45.
12. It closes at midnight during the week.
Okay.
I think 3 o'clock Friday and Saturday.
So during the weekdays, it closes at midnight, okay? Well, the game went on till like 12:15, and it was like the Atlanta game and the Nats, and it was real close, and all these jokers were drunk at the stadium, because that's how you get to the game here in DC. Most people ride the Metro. No one is fucking driving, okay? Fuck that shit. And then they get out the game drunk as shit, get to the Metro, and that joker is closed down. Most of these Bamas live no less than 15 miles away.
Yeah, they be traveling
in fucking
Virginia
and Maryland. So you're talking about a $50 or $60 fucking cab ride at least. And then Lord knows if you live in Columbia, Occoquan, Frederick, or Montgomery County out past Rockville, you are fucked.
But why should Metro have to pay for that?
Because $100 taxi.
No. I was going to say Metro has to pay like $30,000 just to keep the trains running overtime.
Honestly,
just for the Nationals fans.
Honestly, Metro should run their weekend hours all the time. The train,
I agree.
Like, it's bullshit that we pay so much to ride this piece of fucking shit train, which, by the way, I have another thing I want to say about you motherfuckers over at Metro.
Mm.
But the fact that you fuck us over on service, too, like, who the fuck? Goddamn, dude, 11 o'clock? All right, look, dude, if you do anything past 11:15 in the city, you're fucked. Because even though she says the last trains run at midnight, I have been squirrely fucked at 12:30 if you don't catch the last train out to the burbs. At 11:30.
Okay.
Thank you
for
correcting
me. Yeah, some of them are like 11:45 or somewhere around that
time
point.
Right, and we pay too much for the shit. How much is a train ride to anywhere in New York? Because you were telling me this.
I think right now it's $2.25 no matter where you go. So you can go from like
Brooklyn. You can go from Long Island.
No, who goes to Long Island?
Exactly, but you could go from Long Island all the way to the other side of New York City. They're far as fuck apart. And how much will it cost? $2.
Well, you want me to say $2, but I know that's not the case. So, okay.
Okay. But the fact of the matter is you can go pretty much anywhere in the cool parts of New York City for $2.
Yeah, $2.25.
These motherfuckers in Metro, okay, look. Let me tell you what I had to do this morning, peoples. And I'm going to have to do it in about an hour or so when I go pick my son up from school. And I'm going to have to do it tomorrow and every day of school until I just get tired or die. I have to ride my bike 2.5 miles to get to his school. Me and my son ride, or last year we skateboarded, this year we're bike riding. And we're going to try and do it every day. 2.5 miles. Why? Because to go 4 Metro stops in D.C. during rush hour, which is when kids go to school, cost about $3.60. Maybe 4.
Is that how much it is
now?
Yeah,
4. Each way. It costs me $25, maybe $27, if I was going to take my son to school every day on the train, which is the only way to get there besides walk. But I live in D.C., so fuck a car. Now, to add insult to injury, there used to be ways to get around having to pay all the time on the Metro. Like, if you got a Smart Trip card and you were low on funds, you could you could get on the fucking train without paying any money for one trip.
As long as you had something on the
card,
as like
long as
10
you had
cents
10
or something.
Cents or something on the card.
Yeah.
They just, this right here in the fucking
The Express.
With the Express, our fucking local rag that's on the corner outside the studio. Now, beginning September 1st, you will need at least $1.20 on your smart trip before you can enter the system. Mm-hmm. That's some bullshit.
That is some bullshit.
They already raised it, so if you don't have a smart trip, you pay an extra dollar on top of the regular price per fucking trip. Is it per trip or per card?
I think it's per trip.
Yeah, per trip.
For the paper cards.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if I had paper Metro cards.
But that's only for the tourists, really.
Yeah, that's for the tourists.
Good. They should pay more. Fuck you.
No, not fuck them.
Well, no, because they do bring in a lot of money here, but yes. Whatever.
And also, come on, let's be honest, man. Fucking some of the best looking bitches that be coming through this city are tourists. I love when I see a group of hot looking bitches that don't speak my language.
English.
And speak English. And I can stare at them, especially when they're Asian or some other shit like that, which means that they are what?
Underage? What?
No, tourists. Tourists, okay. Not underage.
I don't know. I didn't know where you were getting it.
You're killing me today.
No, because you know what? Asians sometimes look really, really young. Like, you can't really tell their age.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, anyways.
So that was your Metro rant.
Yeah, the fuck Metro.
Yeah.
But I am kind of happy that school started back up. Because, you know, believe it or not, as much as I love my little man. God damn, dude. It is fucking great to be able to park him somewhere where supposedly he's learning something.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
DC public schools don't foul.
Yeah, don't let me down. Let's do a fucking. What about music video?
That'd be cool.
What
are you thinking about?
I don't know. Let me see. I got one. Let me go with, you know what? Fuck a music video.
What?
We're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do a skateboarding video. Once again.
That's cool. Is there music in the background?
Yeah, there's music in the background and shit. But this is once again why y'all might just really, really, really want to go to youtube.com/AceAndAJack.
It is the only way, and I mean the only way, that you're going to get to see this kicking ass skateboarding video that we're about to show.
So, yeah, you need to fucking go there. And this is Darren Harper from Everywhere I Go.
And Darren is local. He's from D.C.,
yeah,
right?
Darren's from D.C. I probably will show some other Bamas that ain't from D.C. on videos and stuff, but nah, man. Right about now, I'm all about DC and what DC's up to. So, it's Darren Harper, Everywhere I Go. Enjoy.
I spit lyrics and don't carry nothing up in the waist. Got spit coming on the camera all up in your face. Cats is mad, he must want to get punched in his face. I'm the cat to give it to you with no hesitation. Move straight, clap him off, ask Aryan Nation. I spit lyrics off the tails, how I do when I flip. I've been to Oregon and made him sucks the dick. Style is real up off of hinges when I'm smoking that shit. I don't mean that sherm stick. Cats move when I flick. And my man Darren holding it down off the tip. My style's off the hinge, so the style of flip flow. Any nigga Pulaski got parked, please let it go.
I make money, money don't make me, I get bread. That's why they
that's
hate me.
That's a nigga sick as shit, by the way.
It's in my lap and it ain't on safety. But you can't break me. I make money. Money don't make me. I get bread. That's why they hate me. It's in my lap and it ain't on safety. You can hate me, but you can't break me. It's smell like money in the air when we pull up to the club. Like, yeah, we here. We ain't on the guest list, but we don't care. Cause we gon' buy more bottles than you usually sell. You can see it, you can smell it. It's a given. You can tell. You hating on
my chronic. Let her get tipsy till she get horny. My chain say hello haters, and then I watch they eyes say hello paper. But please don't attempt to take it. What I'm holding in my lap, only God can save you. I make money, money don't make me. I get bread, that's why they hate me. It's in my lap and it ain't on safety. You can hate me, but you can't break me.
That nigga is sick as sick as sick as sick. Sick.
Oh my God, dog.
Oh my God, dog. I'm lucky to be alive.
Oh my God. Thank you, God.
You're welcome.
I heard about it and I liked it. Because
I'm sorry, he wasn't talking to me.
It was almost like graffiti, but then it looked at prestige too. You know what I mean?
Right, exactly. Exactly what Ghostface said. Yo, yo, DC, we are back. Smurf?
Yeah.
Are you still with me?
I'm still here.
That's good to know. That's good to know. Now, we're about to get into yo motherfucking news, so let me get you set up and ready. Are you ready? Are you ready to go?
Yeah, soon as we pull up the pages.
Kick it like goddamn Van Damme. All right. Pull up your news pages. Let me throw on your news music and set you good. Ladies and gentlemen, I think the computer is fucking up again, but we hear my friends and hopefully we can make it through Miss Smurfette and her news. No, I still get sad every time I play that song now. Because, you know, when we started doing the show and Miss Smurfette's news, all the Beastie Boys were fucking alive. Okay? So now I'd be like, now that Mike D's dead, I'd be like, damn, dude, every time we play that song, I'm like happy, but I'm kind of sad at the same time. You know what I'm saying, Smurf? Anyways, let me fire off your news stories. And you... let me know. You good?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right. First story.
First story up is about what? The Art Institute? Because the government.
The Art Institute. I went there.
Yeah, well, that's why we're doing the story.
I went there.
Yeah, you did go there. Durr.
I didn't plant this story.
Okay, whatever. Anyway, so they're in the news recently because the U.S. government is apparently suing them for $11 billion in fraud.
$11 billion in fraud? Could I get any of that? Because I owe about $80,000 in bills.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's not the case.
What? I don't know $80,000.
I'm not saying that you don't owe the money, but I'm saying I'm not sure if you can get any of that back. Who knows? So here it is. The Art Institute is one of the nation's largest for-profit school systems where people can receive an education in concentrations like, and I love how they just put photography because, you know, people don't really think you can get a degree in photography.
You shouldn't be able to get a degree in photography.
Look, we need teachers out there. Hey, hey, hey.
If you can't snap a fucking picture on your phone and do Photoshop in 2012, fuck you. You should be alive.
So they have come under fire last month.
Hold on. Let me ask you a question. What? Shouldn't that be like a fucking basic minimum at this point in time?
You should
be able to take a picture with your phone, photography,
that's
and
not
manipulate
photography.
It on Photoshop.
We're talking about lighting and film and different things. It's not just point and shoot.
There's a flash on my Android.
You're like belittling their profession. Like some of them are really, really amazing. Anyway.
I'm sure they are.
All right. So the U.S. Department of Justice has filed a massive lawsuit against the company behind the schools, the Art Institute schools, which is called Education Management Corporation. accusing it of fraudulently collecting $11 billion in government aid and recruiting low-income students for the purpose of collecting student aid money.
That's 100% what the fucks they do. Really? As a matter of fact, the Art Institute in D.C., and I am not trying to insult any of my niggas that go to school there. Still friends with a lot of them. Professor Tillman, we are cool with him. Remember we saw him at Comic-Con, the guy that runs the media arts, and we saw Elvin Hernandez that works there. Cool shit with him. Young, seriously, this school goes to the hoods of D.C. and PG County and recruits kids that they know ain't got the fucking money to pay it. Their parents ain't got the money to pay it. The chances of them getting the money to pay it is not going to fucking happen unless they get a job. Unless they definitely get a job.
Yeah. Especially with those loan amounts. Yeah.
And it's the most expensive fucking school. But they'll let you in the motherfucker because they know how to work the system and get that money from the government.
Right.
And then once you get about 2.5 years in, all the money's fucking gone and you're fucked with a big student loan bill. You don't know how many fucking people I know have not graduated Art Institute because they kept raising the price on the fucking, on the credit hours.
But they're a for-profit school, and that's just what they do. Most for-profit schools work the same way.
Right. Now, I want to say one thing with that said. I truly believe, at least in the case of Art Institute DC and the Media Arts and Animation Department, that those teachers up there were top shelf. I learned so much fucking shit. I'm not even going to fucking front like I didn't learn shit. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But are there jobs for what the fuck I learned around here?
Right.
No.
Right.
There ain't no fucking jobs for that shit around here.
So the article goes on to say that whistleblowers claim that students graduate loaded with debt and without the means to pay off the loans, which are then paid for with taxpayer dollars. And they just, I guess, use the example of photography as one of the concentrations, because at one of the schools, they're graduating like 600 photography students, you know, and it's like, where are all these jobs going? Like, these people are concentrating in an area where there's not that
Look,
high
Professor,
of a demand.
Professor Tom Likas on his Monday shows, that's at blowmeuptom.com, by the way, people, one of the greatest talk show hosts of all time on the internets. Listen to it. But he does a money show where he's talking about stupid ass things to go to school for.
Yeah.
And I wish I probably still would have gone to school even if he had been doing the show and you know, beforehand, but I would have thought about it a bit more. Most of these motherfuckers, come on, you going to school for photography? Get a fucking camera and get some bus tickets or plane tickets places and go and take pictures, okay?
Well, the only way it'd be worth it is if you're going to be a teacher of photography, really.
And it's kind of like the culinary. They teach culinary at Art Institute. Come, mm-hmm. Man, dude, look, most of you going to be working in Outback. You might as well just go straight to Outback. The Mexicans, you don't see them going to fucking
Art Institute to work.
Young, dude, I didn't work Mexican work, and none of them motherfuckers went to Outback first to get goddamn degree in culinary. And remember the 300 pounder I fucked? Yeah, I remember the story. She went to Art Institute as well. And where the fuck was she working? California Pizza Kitchen. Bitch, you don't need a goddamn $80,000 culinary degree to work at California Pizza Kitchen. By the way, she is a listener. Big up to her. Her baby is very, very cute.
Wow, okay.
No, she listens to the show all the fucking time. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Bunch of just like me. You know what? In retrospect, maybe I didn't need to fucking rack up a whole bunch of money to learn a lot of the shit in animation and what I'm doing now with the new media stuff.
Yeah.
But it was a really good experience. I met a lot of cool people there.
Right?
Yeah, but you follow your dreams in the debt.
Yeah.
Being poor like
Sometimes
a motherfucker.
Sometimes you just be like that, you know?
Yep. We over
it? It doesn't always have to be. Yep.
Yeah, it doesn't always. Come on, dude. My bad. That's better. That one was better.
Better.
Next story.
The next story up is about this guy named Paul Ryan.
This guy. This guy might end up being the fucking president.
I thought he was the vice president nominee.
Right. If they fucking win and then someone offs Mitt Romney for being a fucking Mormon, this guy is going to be running the country. So let's find out about this motherfucker.
Right. So he's in the news. Well, recently. Yeah. Well, yeah. Whatever. But he's in the news, and the controversy is...
he looks like
is,
a fucking douchebag piece of shit, young. He looks like an evil motherfucker. He looks like he's lying to Ray. I don't trust you. Put your thumb down, bitch.
You
Put your thumb down.
You think
I'll trust you.
So Paul Ryan has sponsored a bill that would allow rapists to stop their victims from aborting.
Now, I really don't trust you.
Really?
You gotta let this motherfucker become president? That is bullshit.
Do I really need to read the story? Isn't that enough?
No, please, keep going.
To most women, Paul Ryan's ideas are pretty much the political equivalent of menstruating forever. I don't even know what that means.
Right. Look, basically, let's get to the bottom disc. Go to the next picture.
Really?
Yeah, go to the next picture. Fuck this article. Go to the next picture. All right. You see,
so this other guy.
Yeah, this motherfucker. I'm sure you heard about him last week. Mr. Foot in His Mouth. Todd Akin.
Yeah.
He said, what did he say? Click the next picture so I can read his quote. He said, first of all, let me get my white voice. My white conservative Republican voice. First of all, from what I understand from doctors, pregnancy from rape is really rare.
Is really rare?
Really rare.
Rare, yeah.
May I ask you a question?
What's your question? Yeah.
What from doctors?
What I understand, you know what? And this is the sad part because there were doctors that actually came out and said that. Yes, real MD medical doctors that said that.
Okay.
But and this is where he got his information from.
Let me get back into my white
man's voice. Yeah.
If it's legitimate rape, the female body has ways to try and
shut that whole thing down. Legitimate rape. Yeah.
Legitimate rape.
That's what got me. Like, what is legitimate rape?
Young, you have to be so fucked in the head to come up with a new term from two words that have been around forever that no one thought to put together, like legitimate and rape.
Yes. Like, rape is rape. Like, what is legitimate rape?
Right. You know what I'm saying? Legitimate rape. What does that mean? You fucking pay to get raped? That's not rape. It's called a fantasy.
Like, okay.
I mean, there's a whole category on Pornhub for that.
Yeah, but he said that the female body has ways to try to shut the whole thing down. And I guess later on he was explaining that, you know, the body's so tense and, you know, the woman is going through all these different emotions at the time that, you know, the sperm can't possibly make its way to the egg. So, conception is not possible.
That means when Todd Akin was in fucking college and he raped a bitch, he pushed her down the stairs to get rid of that baby.
Is that what you think happened?
That's what he meant. But anyways,
This
motherfucker and that motherfucker, Paul Ryan, may have tried to put through a bill that says that rapists can stop a motherfucker from aborting the baby. That is horrible.
Yeah, well, the bill, I suppose, from what I'm reading, I didn't really read the whole story, but it's saying that it wants to give the states rights to make abortion illegal. So it wants
Could
to give,
you imagine if you had to look in the eyes of a fucking rape baby?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude. I'd throw that fucker.
How would you even
know
it's a rape baby?
No,
oh, you mean if it was your own?
If you were the woman and you had to raise this kid because these motherfuckers won't let you abort it and somehow...
I'd move to another state.
Yeah, but let's just say you don't have the option. Let's say you live in the middle of Iowa where there's no trains, no planes, you're piss poor, you got raped by your stepdad. Okay, so anyways, you wanted to get an abortion, but you couldn't. So now you got to see this little motherfucker every day. How fucked up would that be? I'd throw that fucker off the Anacostia if I was a chicken.
See, if you're going to do all that, you might as well just get rid of it before it's born.
Exactly. But he's trying to make it so you can't get rid of it before it's born, which is the whole point. Why?
He's trying to make it... Okay, whatever. He's trying to make the states able to decide on their own if it should be legal or illegal. But, you know, the states shouldn't be able to decide that. It should be each person's or each woman's decision. Whatever.
By the way...
What?
Mitt Romney... Just wanted to go ahead and say thank you for making it this much easier for fucking Obama to get reelected.
I don't know.
Well, you know, first off.
I'm on the fence about that.
First off, you know what? If the nigga don't get reelected, then we get what we pay. We're going to pay for what we got, you know? If we get this motherfucker that's going to stop people from getting abortions and shit... And a fucking Mormon, first off, anybody that's done any history on the Mormon religion, all the fairy tales are fucked up, but that one's really fucking stupid. Don't even make sense. Almost as bad as Scientology. And matter of fact, might be worse because at least Scientology is a funny story. You know, it's so far gone that it has space aliens and shit. The Mormons believe that this motherfucker... like read some tablets that he never proved existed... And that Jesus or an Indian or some shit. I don't know. Book of Mormon. Go look it up. You know, some shit like that. But this is what we're going to have as fucking presidents. I don't think that's going to happen. We've never had a non-Christian president. So that's one good thing.
At the same time, another fact just to throw at you, something that I read today.
What?
There has not been a president that has been elected when unemployment rates were over 8%. Right now, unemployment rates are 8.3%. So that's not looking good on Obama.
Yo, it's not this nigga's fault that people ain't got jobs.
I understand, no, but people are mad.
Yo, it's not Obama's
people
fault.
People are mad
you ain't got
and they
jobs.
Hurting. So if you're
it's
not doing Bush, anything
it's,
about
it's
the situation.
It's 8 years of Bush that we are recovering from. That is why people ain't got jobs. Yo, it's this fucking war in the Middle East.
It's the war that is still continuing on today.
Yeah, but see, the thing is, this nigga didn't start the war. He don't know what Illuminati fucking tactics are going on.
I was just throwing that little tidbit out
there. That's the one thing I want to tell these motherfuckers that are like, ooh, Obama could stop the war. No, that nigga can't stop shit by himself, okay? And there are some plans that are going on that, believe me, no one's stopping that goddamn war until we own the Middle East. Fuck what you heard, okay? That's not war. It's a takeover. Get over it, okay? We're going to have fucking McDonald's and goddamn Afghanistan in 2 years. Tops. Bet.
I'm still going to say I don't know about that.
And you know what? If Obama don't win, you know what? Good. I'm going to say good. Because maybe things need to get a little bit worse.
Really?
I mean, we have mass shootings every day, and people are poor, and we have a war going on against someone that I thought we killed that motherfucker. I thought we did kill that motherfucker that flew the planes into the building. We killed him. When we killed Hitler, didn't that end the war?
Hitler?
Yeah, but when they killed him, it was over, right?
Yeah. Or something like that.
So when they killed Osama bin Laden, the war should have been over.
Well,
right? I mean, when you think about it, in theory, that's the point. You kill the person.
Well, things don't really end immediately, but yeah, things take time.
But you get my point, right?
Yeah, understood. Right.
Anyways, we get what we deserve. Next story. Fuck him.
Next story up is about the Vatican.
Oh,
or the Roman Catholic Church.
Some other creepy shit that we get to talk about.
All right. And this one is about the Vatican because he ordered his butler to stand trial. And he's standing trial because he actually leaked some documents.
That motherfucker looks so creepy.
He does. It's all in the eyes, isn't it? It's like a
yo,
very
Catholic people, can
scowling,
I ask you a question real quick? I'm sorry to interrupt, Smurfy. And by the way, it is so good to have you back.
Is it?
Doing the news. Aww. I missed you.
Have you?
Yes. Crazy bitch. All right, now.
All right, buddy. Whatever.
Look, this motherfucker looks so creepy, yo. Like, I mean, he's holding a gold staff scepter. This what? What? Go back to my picture. Oh, you just click it. That's all you gotta do. Yes, people, we are talking about the video system and whatnot. It's so awesome. We get to put up pictures, but we have to talk about it at the same time. So you're going to hear some crosstalk.
Oh, I love this one.
I mean, look, that motherfucker looks evil. Catholic people, let me get back to what I wanted to ask you. Really, is this with who you want to place your faith? I mean, like, dude, this guy looks like the fucking emperor. And Star Wars. This motherfucker looks like
Lord
Palpatine.
You know what? That's a very good point.
Looks like Lord Palpatine minus the face burns. You know, when Samuel Jackson Jedi turns him into fucking the fucked up face and shit. He looks like before his face got fucked up. He looks like the Emperor.
Well, the Vatican not this past Monday, but recently, ordered Pope Benedict's former butler to stand trial for leaking documents that alleged corruption in the Holy See.
That's something the Emperor would do in fucking Star Wars. That is something. That's exactly what the Emperor would do. He'd be like, "You leaked our documents about the Death Star."
So his butler, his name is Pablo Gabriel, was arrested last May for leaking a 35-page
document.
Yo,
I bet you Pablo got molested as an ultra boy.
You think so?
Yeah, he looks like it.
Why would he even still like work within the system then?
To bring him down. That was his whole deal.
You think so?
Hell yeah.
That's a very good point. But apparently he was like working with other people, other religious people that didn't like the corruption that was going on within the Roman Catholic Church as well.
Oh, really? Dude, you guys should have been used to that shit. It's been going on for the last, like, 2,000 years.
A very long time, right?
Long time.
Yeah, so the Pope ordered him to stand trial. So basically, they're punishing him for telling the truth and trying to uncover all the corruption.
Like, that sounds like some shit the Catholic Church would do.
Does it?
Yeah.
I was trying to cover things up.
Catholics, honestly, I didn't grow up Catholic. I definitely don't believe in the shit. I don't know. It's just weird. 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 Next story. Next story.
Toys R Us.
Oh, I don't want to grow up.
I love that story when I was younger.
I'm a Toys R Us kid.
With a giraffe. What was his name? Did he have a
Jeffrey?
Name? I don't know.
Had to be. I bet you
Jeffrey the giraffe. That just sounds right.
I bet you it is. I bet you if you Google search that, I'm going to Google search it while you're reading. I'm going to Google it.
Read it. So this story is about Michael Pallara and Margaret Pallara, and they are in the news because they are accused of stealing $2 million in toys from Toys R Us.
Yeah, that's a lot of fucking toys. What the fuck are you doing with all those?
Oh, you're about to find out. So they're a mother and son combo from Tamarack, Florida.
Those are mother and son? I thought that was husband and wife.
Are you kidding me?
Nah.
This lady looks old and wretched and damn it to hell, and he looks like half her age. So let's just assume it's mother and son.
Well, you know, white men hold up better than white broads.
Yeah, but they are mother and son, according to the article. He's 46, she's 70.
Okay, they are.
And they're accused of stealing more than $2 million in merchandise from Toys R Us.
Well, good for them. I hope they sold it for some money.
You think? What else would they be selling it for?
I don't know. Crack?
So it was his goal to steal from all 50 states.
That's a fucking awesome goal, dude.
Like, who does that? The son and mother, along with an accomplice, would allegedly enter a store, grab a cheap item in a big box, empty the contents, and hide it in the store. They would then fill the box with smaller, more expensive items, seal it, and pay only the price for the original expensive item.
That's what's up. That's the old 7-Eleven trick.
How do you do
trick?
All this that is, inside yo, the store?
First off, the reason you can do all that inside the store is because most of these stores don't have any security. Take it from someone who's worked at Macy's, Hex, Kmart, Target, and
there's
a rack
cameras.
Other places. No, they don't have them. They really don't have them. They're bullshit-ass cameras.
Oh, they're
they
fake
just
ones.
Sit there.
They're dummies.
Yeah, they're dummies.
Wow, I didn't know
and
that.
And here's the other thing. A lot of places that do have cameras, they're just recording. There's no one actually fucking watching this shit.
Hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, especially now that they're cutting back. Oh, dude, yeah, they definitely be coming back, yo. But they pulled the 7-Eleven joint where you get a super large Slurpee.
Mm-hmm.
And you fill it up with candy in the candy aisle.
What the hell?
And then you fill it up with a Slurpee. And then you find they bring you up for the Slurpee and you fucking go
And
out.
Then you have a messy candy. Like,
no,
who does
because
that?
All the candies are wrapped in plastic.
Wait,
you
wait,
get, like,
wait,
the gummy
wait.
Bears and
Pause.
The fucking
That's doing way too
and
much.
Shit like that.
That's way too much for some gummy bears.
No, it's not.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like. So Pallara, with the help of his mother, would sell the stolen items on their internet and use the proceeds to finance trips around the world. Sounds nice, doesn't it?
That sounds great. Until you get caught.
And that's what happened to them.
Yep.
So Margaret Pallara faces 6 counts for grand theft, petty theft, criminal conspiracy, and organized scheme to defraud, and is being held in a detention facility on bail. That's about $30,000. They say $29,100. Like, bitch, that's $30,000.
That is $30,000.
And that is the story. The that son, Michael Pallara, is facing 13 charges. So that was that. And is being held for $320,000. Which is way more than the mom. But, you know, this was his whole idea.
His whole idea.
His idea.
His
yes.
idea.
It was his goal.
It was his goals.
His dream in life.
Well, you know what?
What?
We are going to take a commercial break.
Uh-huh.
Yo, yo, DC. We will be right back. For people watching the video show, this is probably where the video is going to end, and then you go to the next goddamn video that says Miss Smurfette Snooze. Ha-ha! I'm hilarious! Be right back.